point of grace. The history of mankind is littered with amazing stories of men who experienced and met their point of grace head on. Unfortunately, some rebellious men missed God's midnight cry in their final hour this side of heaven and paid dearly. It is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God, being unreconciled with him. And as it is appointed unto men once to die, but after this the judgment. Just like in our race to life at conception, God blessed us with his grace, culminating into our glorious birth on these earthly shores. The point of grace is the day of reckoning, when God draws the final line for the sinner to choose between life and death, light or darkness. This line is a border where the man is granted the final chance to repent before eternity curtains descend upon him. The point of grace is God's final clarion call for man to repent from his sins. Our God is the God of justice and the one true God. Come on home, this is your last chance to return. The point of grace is today and now, the hour of repentance. Tomorrow is never given, because there is no tomorrow in eternity. While it is said, today if you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts, as in the provocation, in the wilderness where your fathers tempted God and the Lord banished them for 40 long years. Moses would have had his glorious moment in entering the land of promise, the city for which he sacrificed his whole life in Egypt, where he was raised like a pharaoh. God punished Moses for striking the rock twice instead of holding his rod over it as God had instructed him. The children of Israel's rebellion caused the prophet to irritate God. God put Moses over a hill and showed him the land of promise from a distance. Moses, come over here and see it with your own eyes, but you shall not enter into it. The children of Israel caused the prophet to miss his point of grace. The kingdom of Nineveh had their point of grace moment when the king and his people repented in sackcloth and ashes. Jonah the prophet did not even celebrate this greatest miracle because the man didn't believe his own gospel. Jonah thought Tarshish was more convertible than Nineveh, and the Lord proved him wrong. We still have our modern day Jonahs, skeptical preachers who doubt the power of the gospel of Christ by preempting negative response from their audiences. How sad, and when will we ever learn? The point of grace. Saul of Tarsus thought he was serving the Lord God of Israel by persecuting and killing the believers in the early church, but heaven proved him wrong. Jesus turned this religious zealot into the most compassionate preacher of the gospel of Christ. Saul met his point of grace on his way to Emmaus, armed with the letter from the religious leaders authorizing him to kill every believer in sight. The point of grace. Who can forget the legendary testimony Apostle Paul delivered in front of King Agrippa as a prisoner for Christ, accused of preaching the gospel? Agrippa thought it was Paul who should be grateful to appear before him, and yet it was the king who was standing in the presence of heaven. Wow, Paul. King Agrippa, do you believe in the prophets? I know you do. Then Agrippa said unto Paul, almost thou hast persuadest me to be a Christian. Almost persuaded, just like the religious leaders who demanded a sign from Jesus, King Agrippa missed his point of grace and died in his sins, unreconciled with God, and now awaits the judgment day in his grave. We live in the last days. Many people are deceived into thinking they are following Christ when they've been duped into men's doctrines of demons and worship these charlatans as their idols. Going to church for these fools is like going to heaven. The true gospel of Christ points all sinners to the cross, and never use church membership as a prerequisite to know God. Where two or three are gathered in my name, I shall be in their midst. The very reason why the early believers never owned any church buildings. You don't need to join any church to enter the kingdom of God. Believe in me and the one who sent me. I had my point of grace as a young high school student in the 80s. Lord, remember me in your kingdom, cried the thief dying alongside the cross of Christ. Tonight, thou shalt be with me in paradise. What a glorious point of grace.